हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर कीर्ति श्रीराम कुलकर्णी एंड आई एम फ्रॉम गोखले एजुकेशन सोसाइटीज आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज जवार। सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड द SYBSE केमिस्ट्री पेपर 3, दैट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू एनालिटिकल केमिस्ट्री एंड स्टैटिस्टिकल ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ एनालिटिकल डेटा। सो दिस इज अवर 7th लेक्चर। सो फार नाउ वी हैव सीन वॉट इज केमिकल एनालिसिस एंड वॉट इज एनालिटिकल केमिस्ट्री, वॉट आर इट्स सिग्निफिकेंस, राइट, वॉट इज द पर्पज ऑफ केमिकल एनालिसिस। देन वी हैव ऑल्सो सीन सम टर्मिनोलॉजीज इन्वॉल्व इन दिस चैप्टर। देन वी हैव ऑल्सो सीन द सैम्पलिंग टेक्निक्स, ओके, वाई सैम्पलिंग इज इम्पॉर्टेंट। सो वेन एवर यू परफॉर्म एनी एक्सपेरिमेंट, वॉट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू टेक sample, you have to collect a sample from your required area and then you will actually perform experiment in your laboratories, okay. So depending upon the nature of your bulk material, that is solid, liquid or gases, sampling can be done, okay. So we have also seen various method of sampling of gases, liquids and solid in our last lecture. So now what is our term? First we will collect our sample and then in our laboratories we will perform the experiment. So how you will perform the experiment? Using classical methods or non-classical method of analysis, right? So to obtain the result you have to perform experiment using classical methods or non-classical methods, and finally you will represent your data by doing calculation, you will obtain your result. So whenever you are performing any experiment, it is very necessary to follow the proper procedure of sampling, proper procedure of your experiment and also proper procedure of calculation, okay. Then and then only you will get correct result from your data, okay. So whenever you want result of analysis, what are the three basic criteria? Reliability, reproducibility and accuracy. These three are very important concept in your analytical chemistry. So whenever you perform your experiment, you are taking maximum care in each and every step to get perfect result, okay, or we get accurate result. What are the care you are taking? For the sampling, for your actual experiment and during your calculation. But in spite of all these systematic procedures that you are following and the care you are taking during your experiment, there is always a degree of uncertainty or error in your results. Okay, this always happens. We say that, okay, I have done it with utmost care, but how this type of error has occurred, I don't know. Okay, means there is always difference in your expected value and your observed value. We never get complete 100% accurate result as expected, right? So these type of error are called as also uncertainty, okay? And these uncertainties are responsible for deviation of observation from its true value, okay? So while performing your experiment or performing your sampling, there has to be some kind of imperfection because of which it affects your final data or final result, and therefore there is always difference between your observed value, tumhala milaleli value and true value, ji tumhala expected value ahe, tyachya madhe kay alela asto, difference alela asto, ani ya difference lach apan kay mhanto, error, okay. So what is our job now? Our error should be minimum. आपली एरर कशी असली पाहिजे? मिनिमम किंवा कमीत कमी असली पाहिजे. सो इट इज नेसेसरी टू मिनिमाइज ऑर डिक्रीज द मॅग्निट्यूड ऑफ एरर, ओके. मॅग्निट्यूड मीन्स इट इज अ क्वांटिटी अँड दॅट क्वांटिटी शुड बी मिनिमाइज ऑर रिमूव्ड. सो इट इज नॉट ऑलवेज पॉसिबल टू रिमूव कम्प्लिटली ऑर 100% द एरर. सो वॉट वी कॅन डू, वी कॅन मिनिमाइज इट टू गेट सफिशियंटली ॲक्युरेट रिझल्ट ॲट acceptable level of experiment, okay. So for the error also there is always some acceptable level. Up to that level we can accept the error in our final results, okay. सो आता या एरर कुठून येतात, कशा येतात हे जर आपल्याला माहिती असलं तरच आपण काय करू शकतो, त्या एरर मिनिमाइज करू शकतो. ओके, सो व्हॉट आर दीज एरर दॅट वी विल सी नाउ. सो एरर इन अनालिसिस आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स. ओके, तुमच्या अनालिसिस मध्ये या ज्या एरर येतात ज्याच्यामुळे तुमची ट्रू व्हॅल्यू आणि ऑब्झर्व व्हॅल्यू याच्यामध्ये डिफरन्स येतो, त्या कोट किती टाईपच्या आहेत, दोन टाईपच्या, डिटर्मिनेट एरर अँड इनडिटर्मिनेट एरर. ओके, सो डिटर्मिनेट एरर आर दोज विच कॅन बी मेजर्ड अँड अकाउंटेड इन डिफायनाईट मेजरेबल व्हॅल्यू. इन सिम्पल लँग्वेज वी कॅन से दॅट द लोकेशन ऑफ डिटर्मिनेट एरर कॅन बी फाइंड आउट. म्हणजे डिटर्मिनेट एरर कुठून आल्या, कशा आल्या हे आपण फाइंड आउट करू शकतो आणि त्याच्यामुळेच आपण त्यांना कमी करू शकतो. सो फायनली व्हॉट कॅन बी इनडिटर्मिनेट एरर, देअर ओरिजिन कॅनॉट बी डिटरमाइन. त्या कुठून आल्या, कशा आल्या हे आपण फाइंड आउट करू शकत नाही. सो दॅट इज द लेटर पार्ट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डिटर्मिनेट एरर कॅन बी लोकेटेड अँड मेजर्ड. ओके, डिटर्मिनेट एरर आपल्याला डिटरमाइन करता येतात, त्यांचं लोकेशन फाइंड आउट करता येतं आणि त्याच्यामुळेच आपण त्या मिनिमाइज पण करू शकतो. सो दे आर ऑल्सो नोन ॲज सिस्टमॅटिक एरर. ओके, सो डिटर्मिनेट एरर ऑफ फोर टाइप्स, इन्स्ट्रुमेंटल, मेथॉडिक, ऑपरेशनल अँड पर्सनल. ओके, सो फॉलोइंग दिस फोर मेथड वी कॅन फाइंड आउट व्हॉट आर ॲक्च्युली डिटर्मिनेट एरर आर. ओके, सो द फर्स्ट वन इज कॉल्ड ॲज इन्स्ट्रुमेंटल एरर. ओके, सो ॲज द नेम इट सेल्फ सजेस्ट यू, दे आर अराइज ड्यू टू फॉल्ट्स इन द टूल्स, अपॅरेटस ऑर इन्स्ट्रुमेंट्स यूज्ड बाय अनालिस्ट. ओके, द पर्सन हु इज परफॉर्मिंग एक्सपेरिमेंट इज कॉल्ड ॲज अनालिस्ट. ओके, अँड व्हॉट एवर टूल्स ही इज युझिंग ऑर अपॅरेटस ही इज युझिंग, इफ दे आर फॉल्टी देन इन्स्ट्रुमेंटल एरर ऑकर. ओके, इट कॅन बी ऑल्सो ड्यू टू रॉंग ऑर इम्प्रॉपर कॅलिब्रेशन ऑफ ग्लासवेअर, वेट्स, इम्प्युअर केमिकल्स, इनकरेक्ट रिडिंग एक्सेट्रा. नाउ व्हॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस, व्हेनेवर यू आर परफॉर्मिंग एक्सपेरिमेंट द कॅलिब्रेशन ऑफ ग्लासवेअर कॅन बी इम्प्रॉपर. ओके, तुमचे ब्युरेट, पिपेट, ओके, कोनिकल फ्लास्क याच्यावरती काय असतात, मार्किंग केलेले असतात, बरोबर, अँड इफ दे आर फॉल्टी देन ऑब्विसली इन्स्ट्रुमेंटल एरर विल ऑकर. ओके, द नेक्स्ट वन इज इवन लेस सेन्सिटिव्ह इक्विपमेंट्स ऑर व्होल्टेज फ्लक्च्युएशन कॅन कॉज इन्स्ट्रुमेंटल एरर्स. ऑब्विसली द इन्स्ट्रुमेंट ॲट अवर होम दॅट इज फ्रीज, टीव्ही, दे ऑल्सो गेट अफेक्टेड ड्यू टू व्होल्टेज फ्लक्च्युएशन्स. So whatever experiment we are performing, if our instruments are sensitive, then they will always get fluctuated or giving wrong result due to voltage fluctuation. Also less sensitive equipment, suppose your concentration is very very small or very very small, then what you have to do? You have to use a particular sensitive equipment for that. But suppose the capacity of instrument is not up to that level, it will give you instrumental error. Okay, also some instruments are sensitive or giving proper result at particular temperature. Okay, and they are calibrated in that way, but suppose that temperature is exceeded more than the required, then what will happen, the calibration get disturbed and your measurement become unreliable. Okay, so you have to take all this care while handling your instrument. So this is all type of faults which are coming through your instruments. Okay, so all these types are called as instrumental errors. The next one is called as methodic error. Okay, what is that? The methodic error, the name itself will tell you that this will occur due to error in the method itself. Whatever experiment procedure is there, if there is fault in that, you will have methodic error. Okay, first one, these error arise due to reaction under study are not going to completion or occurrence of side reaction. Okay, suppose you are performing chemical kinetic experiment. Okay, and there you want your reaction to go in one particular direction. But suppose it is not going to complete, or you get some side product or side reaction, then obviously there will be error. Also, these errors occur directly in procedure or method of experiment. Whatever handbook you follow or whatever other book you follow where their procedure is mentioned, if it is faulty, then you get this type of error. Okay. Suppose you are doing gravimetric experiment. Okay. And in that gravimetric experiment, suppose you are following insignificant steps, then also methodic error will happen. So, for example, incomplete washing of precipitate or co-precipitation or post-precipitation during gravimetry. Okay, so how you can explain that? See, your compound, whenever you perform your experiment, should be completely pure form. But suppose the precipitate you are generalizing in your experiment, you are not properly washing it. Okay. So, washing is very important to remove the impurities. So, incomplete washing will leave impurities as it is. And suppose you give more number of washing, जर तुम्ही requirement पेक्षा जास्त वेळा precipitate wash केली, then it will dissolve the precipitate to significant level. So, both incomplete washing and overwashing are methodic errors. Okay? Similarly, co-precipitation and post-precipitation. There is formation of co-precipitate and post-precipitate take place during your main precipitation. It will also give you methodic error in your gravimetry. So, are you getting this point? This type of error directly occur due to fault in your procedure or method in your experiment. Now we will see the third type, that is called as operational error. Okay, पहिल्या दोन method कशामुळे येत होत्या? पहिल्या म्हणजे fault of instrument, दुसरा fault of method. तुमची जी procedure आहे तीच जर faulty असेल तर तुम्हाला methodic error येतात. But now this is called as operational error. Here these error occur due to improper operation during experiment. आता ह्या ज्या एरर आहेत ह्या तुमच्या रॉंग ऑपरेशन मुळे येणार आहेत, बरोबर? कशा बघा, ड्यू टू लॉस ऑफ प्रेसिपिटेट ड्यूरिंग स्पिलिंग ऑफ सॅम्पल. तुम्ही तुमचं सॅम्पल किंवा प्रेसिपिटेट यू आर कॅरिंग इट फ्रॉम वन पार्ट टू अदर पार्ट अँड यू आर स्पिलिंग इट आउट. तुमची प्रेसिपिटेट जर सांडली तर ऑब्व्हियसली तिकडे एरर येणार आहे. और इनकम्प्लीट ड्राइंग ऑफ प्रेसिपिटेट. It is very necessary to dry out your precipitate completely before weighing. वजन करण्याआधी प्रेसिपिटेट पूर्ण ड्राय झालेली असली पाहिजे. पण सपोज जर ती ड्राय झाली नसेल तर इट विल हॅव मॉइस्चर कंटेंट अँड ऑब्व्हियसली यू विल गेट मोर प्रेसिपिटेट वेट. देन वेईंग ऑफ क्रुसिबल वेन इट इज हॉट. क्रुसिबल नेहमी थंड झाल्यावर, कूल झाल्यावर वजन करायचं असतं. But suppose it is hot, obviously it will give you operational error. And last one is use of indicator more than required quantity. See, many people have this habit that it is always written that 2 to 3 drops of indicator is required. But always we add some more indicator to get better color. That is some idea in our mind. And this is your operational error. This is done by you, right? So, this is also causes some kind of error. Also, cooling the crucible in poor quality desiccator. It is necessary to cool your crucible in desiccator. But suppose that desiccator is of not good quality, then it will contain the moisture and again you will get the wrong result. So, all this type of operational error, the name itself tell you that they come due to wrong kind of operation. So, suppose you perform a perfect kind of operation during your experiment, also during your sampling, you will not get this type of error. And the last one is called as personal error. Okay. First three were because of some different instrument or methods or operation. But personal error are because of the own person. they are different for person to person. Whatever error I am performing, that you will not do, okay, or the third person will have some other error. So these error arise as faulty ideas, carelessness, negligence, ignorance or physical limitation of analyst. So as these all words says, these are all the things that we are performing in our laboratories. We have some faulty ideas in our mind, or we should give carelessness, right? Or negligence. Whatever teacher is telling you, you don't have proper attention to him, or ignorance. You are watching in your mobile or chit-chatting with your friends, and whatever experiment you are doing, you are just ignoring it. So you will get personal error. Also the physical limitation of analyst. Okay. So what is the example? Color blindness. Now suppose a person is color blind, he cannot find out the change in indicator. Okay, change in color of indicator. An indicator has the role to change the color after your completion of reaction. So that color blind person cannot find out change, and he will have personal error. Okay, so color blindness is a problem with a particular person, but also it can occur due to biased approach of analyst. Okay, what is biased approach? While performing our experiment, we encounter with some misconvinced ideas. Okay, the teacher might have taught you, or you have read it somewhere else, and you have some different wrong ideas while performing your experiment. It will lead to personal error. Okay, for example, we always take the last drop from your pipette. Okay, suppose it is told us that we have to take 10 ml of sample. So we will pipette out 10 ml of sample, we will take it in conical flask, and what you will do? You will blow the pipette to take the last drop, or you will warm your bulb of pipette, okay, to take the last drop, and it will give you personal error. Nowadays all your pipettes are calibrated in such a way that it is not necessary to take the last drop. It will directly give you required amount of sample. But it is taught us in our childhood, and therefore we keep on carrying out the same ideas. Okay, so the pipette are calibrated in such a way that they will deliver you required amount of volume. So it is not necessary to take the last drop of it. Okay, then in other word, we can say that whenever you perform experiment, you should have proper and systematic procedure and correct concept in your mind. Okay, you cannot just perform it with your own ideas. Whatever procedure is given, whatever concepts are given, you should follow it in a proper manner. Okay, also the last part, the natural tendency in performing experiment is only wrong. तुम्ही जर एक्सपेरिमेंटच चुकीच्या पद्धतीने करत असाल, तर सुद्धा तुम्हाला काय येणार आहेत? एरर येणार आहेत. ओके, सो देअरफोर टू अवॉइड पर्सनल एरर, इट इज व्हेरी नेसेसरी टू परफॉर्म युअर एक्सपेरिमेंट इन सिस्टमॅटिक मॅनर. ओके, सो अप टिल नाउ वी हॅव सीन दॅट द डिटर्मिनेट एरर, अशा एरर ज्या आपल्याला फाइंड आउट करता येतात, लोकेट करता येतात, त्या चार टाईपच्या आहेत. ओके, इन्स्ट्रुमेंटल, मेथॉडिक, ऑपरेशनल आणि पर्सनल. जर तुम्हाला या मेथड कमी करता आल्या, या एरर कमी करता आल्या, तर तुमचा रिझल्ट कसा येणार आहे? प्रॉपर आणि करेक्ट येणार आहे. ओके, सो व्हेनेवर यू आर डुईंग सॅम्पलिंग अँड व्हेनेवर यू आर परफॉर्मिंग युअर एक्सपेरिमेंट अँड फायनली यू आर डुईंग युअर कॅल्क्युलेशन, यू शुड फॉलो प्रॉपर स्टेप्स अँड प्रॉपर आयडियाज. ओके, देन अँड देन ओनली यू विल गेट correct result. So what are the further type of error? That we will see in our next lecture. Till that, take care and stay at home safe. Okay, thank you.